So just to clarify, if you're on a client shoot and you got a lot of full body shots, get bigger paper, get a bigger background, get the shot right, compose it perfectly so you don't have to do any of this stuff, especially if you're providing a lot of proofs to a customer. That's not the way to go. All right, once again, we'll do a shot here where I made things difficult for myself. I wanted to use sort of a beige backdrop in the studio. Didn't have one, so I brought my own, and all I had was this smaller backdrop. And, you know, 90% of the shots were three-quarter shots, and really that's what this size background is meant for. Liked her whole outfit, and I know that I can kind of do these some of these tricks in post to get a full body shot with the whole outfit and the boots, and then fill in the edges. It's a lot of work, actually, if it's something you're not used to doing. So you really only want to get, you know, a few shots like this if your background is a smaller background like this and limited, and definitely don't want to make any promises that you'll get full length shots with this. But I know that I can do it, and I just say, look, let's get a couple full length shots, and I'll get you one or two edits like this. So, I mean, when I'm just running through it quickly on my own, it, you know, takes me maybe 10 minutes to do this edit, but I'll go slow and try to explain as I'm going along. So we are going to fill in the edges as if she was if we had a huge beige background behind her. So let's see what we can do. Okay, so let's start by cropping. I'm gonna hit Control minus just to so I can see the entire photo, and we'll choose the lasso tool here. Actually, we'll choose the crop tool, and then we'll click once on the background so it gives us the guidelines here, and then we'll move it over and we'll just get the crop about where I think it should be. I'm just trying to square her up right in the middle, and that's pretty good. And then maybe I'll bring it down just a little bit there. Now, I'm not using content aware crop right now because there's just too much to fill in. So I'm just going to hit enter, and it's going to give me the crop that I want. So step one, just get the crop the way you want it. Step two, we're going to do content aware fill. So let's pick, I'm going to use my lasso tool, and I'm just going to come down here, and I'm going to just highlight the entire left side here and make that selection. And now I'm going to choose edit from the menu, content aware fill. And my options are going to be, maybe I should have moved my camera down here more to the left. Let's do that. There we go. So we can see some of our options. Now, one thing that I do is to set my output settings to the current layer. And then I set this sampling area options to custom instead of auto. Now you can choose auto and it will fill in the area where you want to sample from, right? But that's not really what I want to do here. So I'm going to, it's giving me a preview here, but that's kind of, it's kind of in my way, right? So I'm going to move that out of the way. So what I want to do is come down here and I just want to select the area that I want it to use, create, fill in this area with. So it's going to use these samples of this area in green that I selected. Now, if I had had auto selected over here, it would just fill it in for me, and it might not be exactly what I want. So I always keep that at custom. And then I usually output to the current layer. If you don't choose current layer, you can choose new layer if you want to. I've just done this so many times, I know what's going to happen, and I'll just do it on the background. You might want to do it on a new layer. That way you can go back and undo if you need to, which you have levels of undo, but you know what I mean? You've got it on a separate layer. So I'm going to hit OK. And as you can see, it fills it in pretty well. And I'm not trying to make it perfect at this point. It looks a little funky here with the shadows and things like that, but I've gotten, you know, 80% there. So I'll come over here and I'll do the same thing on the other side. I'm going to go right around this tape, and I'm just going to select that area there, and I'll choose the same thing, edit, content aware fill. Now, if you did it to a new layer, you'll need to flatten it and then do another new layer, because you need to have the background layer that has all the pixels selected in order for this to work. So if you're trying to do the selection and it's on a blank layer, this is not going to work. So make sure you have a layer that has all the pixels showing. Okay. Hopefully that's clear, but you will get an error if you're on one of the blank, like a new blank layer. There's no pixels in it, so there's nothing for it to sample. So again, I'm going to come over here and I'll just pick the area. Try to get as much of a sample as you can. I've got some shadows down here. It's going to get those. There's not a whole lot I can do about it. Now that preview window up here will show you what you're going to get. I minimized it a little bit, but just for the sake of this video, because it was kind of in the way. So again, not perfect, but 90% there, right? I've got this sampled the shadows down here. It is what it is. We're going to fill those in later. So then I'm going to come over here and get as much of that as I can. And this one, we'll do the same. I could try to choose right-click and just choose fill and see what it does. I think it's going to pull some of the hair in. But let me try just the fill. It did all right. It's a little wonky up here. So again, we're about 80% there. Now what I want to do, I'll hit Control Zero to increase the size of the canvas. So now I'll do a new layer. And what I meant before by that content aware fill was if you had this blank layer like this here, that's not going to work. It needs to be a layer that has the full picture in it, right, for that to work. So usually what I'll do is if I was doing it to a new layer on the content aware fill, I'd flatten the image like that. So just a little gotcha there. Now what I want to do, I want to select the subject. And again, you got to have a layer with pixels in it so it knows what to select. If I'm here, there's nothing in there, right? Click a layer that has all your pixels in it, that has the actual picture in it. Choose the quick selection tool, which is the one in the middle there, at least on my menu, quick selection, and then come over to select subject up here at the top. Does a really good job of select subject. You can go in and you can refine the mask up here if you want to. I'm fine with it right there. And then I'm going to right click on the selected area and I'm going to choose select inverse. So that means only the background is selected. She's not selected. So anything I do here, if I color beige or whatever, the whole thing, it's not going to color over her. Make sure you switch back to your blank layer now, this one here. We were just on this layer down here just to be able to select the subject. Now we're going back to the blank layer. I'm going to pick my paintbrush and make sure that your brush is, the hardness is set to 0%. Very important or you'll get streaks. And then I'm going to hold down the Alt or Option and I'm going to start filling these areas in. Now I've got my flow at 20%. Keep it low like that because we want to be, you know, subtle here. And I'm going to sample, hold down the Alt or Option, sample this color here and just start filling that in up there, right? And then we'll take a sample right here and we're just trying to kind of, and I'm trying to kind of create a gradient, right? And I could use a gradient filter to do this later if I wanted to even get better, but I'm just trying to, I don't want it to be a one flat color, right? So I'm sampling colors as I go. Like this is a little lighter, so maybe I'll make it a little lighter through there. And I'll come down over, let's see, pick that color there, start filling this in like that, and pick a little bit lighter color and start going across with it. Let's grab this color here, kind of going there, and we'll do the same thing. Not sure I like that, so I'm going to hit Control Z, which is undo. I'm going to grab a color over here, and kind of go that way. She has kind of an outline around her with the lighting. I kind of like that. So I'm going to kind of grab these lighter colors to kind of blend that in. You see how I'm just kind of make it a little bit smaller, control minus. How I'm just kind of working this in over here, right? And I do kind of have a gradient. I'll grab another color just to try and make it sort of a smoother gradient, right? Now you don't necessarily want to get rid of these shadows because they provide some depth. So I'm going to not go over them completely. I'm going to leave them a little bit. And then down here, maybe I'll grab a little bit right there and I'm going to leave these shadows down here alone. So now you can see that it's lighter down here where the light fall off was hitting down there, but you can see some shadow and it provides a little bit of depth as if she's actually standing on something. like the ground, and not, it's not flat, in other words, behind her. There's a little bit of depth to it. So that's pretty good. I mean, you could refine it a little bit more. This color, this is a little bit, I could grab this here and just kind of fill that in just a little bit more, but that's pretty good. I'll come over here and I'll deselect everything, hit Control Zero to center the canvas, and we're good. I mean, we filled it in. So if we look at the before, it looked like that, and this was after the content aware fill, right? Because I did it on the background layer, but, and then that's the after. So before and after. And then if you really wanted to see the total before, we could go to this here. So that's the actual before and then the actual after. So pretty cool, right? That's all there is to it. We did that in a pretty, in about 10 minutes or so. If I didn't have to explain all this as I was going, it would take me less time. Again, I've been doing this for quite a while, and you really want to, as much as you can, get your shots correct in camera so that you do not have to do this. I will stress that, because you don't want to end up having to do this on 20 shots, right? So just to clarify, with that size paper, you don't want to be doing a full-length shoot, right? This was just, hey, I'm going to get one or two, and I'll give you one or two of them, right? That's it. I'm not going through and doing 20 of these. There's just no way. So keep that in mind. If you're on a client shoot and you got a lot of full body shots, get bigger paper, get a bigger background, get the shot right, compose it perfectly so you don't have to do any of this stuff, especially if you're providing a lot of proofs to a customer. That's not the way to go. This was a collab model shoot, friendly shoot. This is perfectly acceptable to do for that. And, you know, to be frank, there was many, when I was learning, I had to do this a lot because I wasn't getting it right in camera. And that's how I learned to do this. I had to go make these corrections and spend hours and hours and hours, which you don't want to do. So I'm hopefully this is helping you out so you don't have to spend as much time learning it. So I appreciate you tuning in. Appreciate you watching. Don't forget to give it a like and give me a subscribe if you will. It's a very small channel at this point, and I can use all the help I can get. Thank you.